Welcome back into the nest for more intimate chats with the lovebirds. Now, with more discussion about love, sex, and relationships, here are Drs. Chuck and JoAnn Bird.
Welcome back. And you're listening to Intimate Chats with the Lovebirds. And this is going to be a great segment.
Yes, it is.
We are so excited to have Caroline Hatton coming on the show. She was on our show. I think it was our second show she came on. Mm-hmm. And she is a wonderful expert in our community and a good friend. So,
well, thank you for having me back.
Yes.
Caroline is a licensed mental health counselor. She's an ASLE certified counselor. She's been working in the Tampa Bay area for close to 15 years.
She runs
a successful private practice, seeing a variety of clients. She has extensive training and expertise in working with children and families, as well as couples. She spends much of her therapy practice with juveniles and focusing on parenting. However, she can't address the many issues that arise today. You may have seen her on TV, heard her on the radio, and the Intimate Chats with the Lovebird show.
That's right.
Locally, or seen her give talks throughout the community. So welcome, Caroline.
Thanks again for having me.
Yeah, this is, I really think this is especially in honor of STD Awareness Month. This is a very, very important topic that we're covering. You know, not just adults about safer sex practices, but we need to start talking to children about sexuality, of course, age-appropriate sexuality information, positive sex messages, you know, getting that stuff established early.
And I wanted to say, I think one of the biggest things for everybody out there is their biggest fear is just because you educate your kids about it,
means
they think they're going to go out and do it, which is...
And that's not the reality of it. I mean, the research shows out, I guess... worldwide, that in other countries where they're much more open about sex, the their pregnancy rate for teenagers is drastically lower than it is for us in the United States.
What's missing? We're not talking to our kids about this.
It's all hush hush.
Exactly, exactly. And that's the silence is not helping. It's making it worse. Because kids are sexual beings, teenagers are sexual beings, and ignoring that fact, it leads to problems.
Well, when you don't educate somebody, they go out and just try things and experiment, and it gets them in trouble.
Exactly, exactly. And it says here, studies show and they confirm that children want their parents to talk to them about sex. It says here, according to the Planned Parenthood website, and this is Kirby's study in 2007, youth often say they want to discuss sex, relationships, and sexual health with their parents. Parents are the preferred source of information for these subjects, not their friends, not the magazines that they find, you know, exactly. They will find, they're looking for the information. And schools, of course, are teaching abstinence only programs, which again is great. You know, it's the safest sex practice.
Right.
But again, if they decide.
They teach abstinence and they teach anatomy. They don't teach anything else.
They don't teach relationships. They don't teach about how to interact with teenagers, how to talk to them about STDs, about birth control.
None of
besides
that.
Abstinence. And all of those topics need to be addressed.
Exactly. And in fact, in reality, again, from Planned Parenthood, it says not talking with your children about sexuality can lead to higher risk-taking when it comes to sex, which is, Caroline, what you were just saying. 46% of males, 47% of females, ages 15. Now, I know a lot of the parents right now are just kind of, you know,
cringing.
Yeah. 15 to 19 have already begun having sex. Research shows that youth with the least accurate information about sex and sexuality and sexual risk behaviors may experiment more and at an earlier age compared to youth who have had more information.
Right.
So right there, that's a research study.
And it goes back to the more you educate, like knowledge is power.
Exactly.
Teach your kids what's okay, what's not okay, what's legal, what's not legal, and how to make good decisions, whether it be about sexuality or any area of their life. It's funny, we do that as parents when it comes to crossing the street or whether to steal or not. But if you bring up the subject of sex, it's like, don't talk to me about that.
Other safety issues except for that one.
Exactly.
And it's funny because that's creating a problem.
Exactly. And what messages, you know, we often as sexologists work with adults that are coming in our office, and maybe their parents never talked about sex, or, you know, they had certain religious beliefs growing up or whatever was there, but just the fact that they didn't talk about sex, it's amazing the variety of beliefs that are formed from not talking about sex, what people read into, what kids read into that.
Well, it's all misperceptions.
Yes.
They just come up with their own ideas about what it's supposed to be.
Right. And why aren't we talking about it? It must be bad.
And so, and oftentimes kids who are like, oh, it's bad. I got to try it just to see what it's like.
True.
Exactly.
True.
And they say here that the ages, you need to start talking to them, again, age-appropriate discussions, at a very early age so that they can develop this foundation of trust. There's a belief out there that you should have one major conversation.
It's a process.
It is a process.
That starts from the beginning. We teach, the song I always remember saying to my own kids is head, shoulders, knees, and toes.
How they miss a whole part.
They skip
miss the
entire
part. Middle part.
Exactly.
And it's like if they point to something, that you need to be able to give them the words.
Mm-hmm. So the appropriate words.
And then if they're touching one of their private parts, whatever it might be, you need to be able to go, that's what it is, and if you'd like to do that, you need to go in a private place, and you just say it nonchalant.
Right.
Not swat their hand away.
Well, because we know, again, the power of beliefs. Every experience, even when we're younger, we form beliefs that will stay with us
throughout their lives.
Exactly, and it can really affect them as adults. We see it, like I said, all the time. Right. And so, again, not talking about those parts in the song, what are you saying? There's an underlying
taboo.
Message. Yes,
yeah. Taboo.
From here to here, it's
bad,
gone.
Or... Mm-hmm. So we're talking with Caroline Hatton, licensed mental health counselor. What's the best time to start talking to kids about
sexuality? In fact, we actually, on our shout box, on our radio show website, we had that was the question from Cindy, one of our listeners. So,
oh, okay.
When is the best time?
We just said, it's a process. You start from the beginning just labeling body parts. And as kids ask questions as they grow older, answer them in ways that they're able to understand. If a three-year-old goes, how come you have hair there? Or how come you have hair down there? You go, when you get older, your body changes. And that's what happens as you become an adult. And they go, okay. And they walk on. If you go, oh, well, now I have to have the talk with them. You know, it's like they're three. They don't get all that yet.
Or if you say, don't talk about down there.
Right.
Then it's going to be a problem, you know.
Definitely.
That negative message is there.
So we want to keep the messages positive.
Exactly.
And brief, because you don't want to
over-educate
at that moment.
And give the child way too much information. Their eyes start to glow over
about beliefs.
Or the eyes get really big.
Yeah, exactly. I can't believe they're having this conversation.
Or exactly. What are they talking about?
And it's important to actually ask the question, especially of young kids, when they ask a question like, where am I from? You know, again, the parents start to think, oh my gosh, you know, they're asking.
Where do babies come from?
And maybe not. Maybe they're just wanting to know literally what state are they born in? Where do they come from? So you need to ask and see what information they're looking for.
Asking questions is a really good thing to do to find out what it is that they're looking for.
Exactly. Exactly. And there's actually a funny story of that.
Well, let's save that for next segment.
Yes.
Because we're being told we have to go to commercial. Caroline, would you be willing to stay on with us for the next segment?
Yes, definitely.
Excellent.
Fantastic.
All right. Well, you're listening to Intimate Chats with the Lovebirds, and we'll be back after these commercials.
The Lovebirds will be right back with more intimate chats about love, sex, and relationships after these messages.
Me and we're laughing with love at it all.